I just like to go out in the real world and just do tests. And I thought the best place is maybe just to go shoot where we did the original dig. Like, it'd be great to just be in the real environment where the sun is, you know, overexposing and the shadows are underexposing. And it was also a good place for us to test the 3200 ASA of the camera as well. So I thought it'd be a good idea to have some fire in there, which we know is like completely always overexposing with the underexposure. So I thought it was a good dynamic range test for the camera. So we were testing dynamic range, low light sensitivity, highlight roll off, color, skin tones. We also had the first generation Venice as well to test and see, can these two cameras work together for the same project? The first thing you see is you just love the size. It's just a little bit smaller, so you know that you can kind of shoot raw and get it in places where you couldn't do before, which I love. And the second one is the 3200 ASA, which was unbelievably clean at night and totally usable for the big screen. I mean, we were doing some stuff at the very edge of exposure that was, I just thought was really stunning. I feel the Venice 1 and the Venice 2 are pretty much in the same family. I don't feel there's a compromise in shooting both at the same time. We shot them both intentionally. There's a shot where we did both kind of matching overs inside the car, and one of them is Venice 1 and the other is Venice 2. And they cut, and no one will know that they're actually two different cameras. And then we're just kind of showing a little bit of skin tones before we get into before they strike the match for the fire. And I thought just kind of lead us into the dark would be this match shot. And there's still like fidelity in the shadows and everything, even on that match shot. But the wide shot is pretty spectacular where, you know, there is no film lights on this shoot at all. There's just the headlights of the car and the fire and the sky. And that was kind of the whole point, you know, not to have a lighting department really, other than making sure the battery was charged on the car. I mean, that was kind of the whole point of the whole location too, of the test, was to put a big fire in a place and to see how far it was lighting up the mountain, and also look at the detail in the fire and that it wasn't clippy or wasn't distorted. There was still nice highlight roll off in there, even pushing the camera to 3200 ASA. That's the one that really stands out. And when you see that, I think that kind of tells everything. And we were all sitting there. It was, you know, getting darker and darker. And we kind of rolled past the Venice 1, right? You know, into darkness. And, you know, even Venice 1 was kind of lost it. And you were just kind of keep on going on Venice 2. And you just really see that night shot with, and it's just an old car with old headlights. You know, we didn't even modify them, you know, and it's working pretty flawlessly. Also, there's a wide shot at the end of the night, and we're in Lancaster. There's nothing out there. And I was actually surprised to see how much city was out there to the eye. I mean, to the eye, I thought I was in the middle of nowhere. And then when we're kind of shooting, you know, some of the ending shots of the whole piece, that we saw tons of city life out there, surprisingly. Venice 1, you know, handles skin tones really amazingly well. But Venice 2, what I found was very interesting, not only in the daylight, the skin tones were handled really well, but also during the fire, which is a very warm source. What tends to happen is sometimes when the cameras get into that, the fall off into the shadows go deeply red and just feels kind of murky. But what was really kind of nice about the camera is when it does start going into the shadows, it still has a nice filmic curve into black. It doesn't get ruddy it just looks clean. Like, even with this extremely warm fire, that the skin tones look, for me, really natural. I mean, the big difference between the new Venice is just the 3200 ASA is a big deal. You know, that's a ton more light, and how clean it is, I think is something that's definitely very useful.